Good morning, beautiful people. How are you all today? I hope you're feeling fine and fabulous here at the start of July. Let's let that sink in for a second. It's the start of July. That means we're halfway through this year. How has that happened? I know loads of people talk about this, but I'm sure that time does speed up the older you get. Like, honestly, don't know where those 6 months have gone. So yes, halfway through the year, but for the garden year, I always kind of think of my garden year as starting in March with the first few little seedlings at home. But then April and May are the big, big push in the year. Normally by the beginning of June, and we'll come on to this in a sec, I'm settling down into a nice rhythm, tinker time, what have you. And then towards the end of September, right, Rusty, towards the end of September, it all starts to fade and calm down. So that by the middle of October, I've done a lot of my harvesting, a lot of the plants are out, and I'm starting to top things up for winter. So, in terms of the garden year, it's about a third of the way through. However, for me this year, I feel like I'm only a quarter in, if that makes sense. There's no doubt about it, my garden is a bit late this year. Not so much with things like, say, tomatoes, squash and cucumbers, because I wouldn't ever put those out to the beginning of June anyway, and that's they sort of went out within the first couple of weeks of June. Pretty much everything else, brassicas, carrots, parsnips, climbing beans, all that stuff that I direct sow, potatoes even, they're all definitely, I feel they're about anywhere between sort of 3 and 4 weeks behind. And, you know, if you look at a lot of other gardens on YouTube, mine looks considerably less lush than so many other people's. It would be easy for me to get disheartened by that, but I'm not, because firstly, you know, my garden is my garden, someone else's garden is their garden. We do things differently, we're on a different time scale. I'm definitely on a different time scale to everyone else this year, but I hope by showing it to you today that for any of those of you who also got a bit of a late start, and this is really particularly pertinent to anyone who started their first garden this year because of lockdown, you will probably be at a similar stage to me. And what I will say is, you know, things do catch up, and even things that don't catch up, at least here in the UK, at least in the southern part of the UK, we generally have quite warm, mild, pleasant autumns right through to the end of October, even into November. So there should be plenty of time for your plants to develop, for your veggies and fruits to ripen and come to fruition. So please don't panic, and that's a note to self. Yeah, so definitely behind. Now the other thing to say today is I haven't been to the garden for six or seven, nearly a week basically, just been trying to catch up with things at home. And during that week, we've had quite a lot of drizzle. The weather has completely changed from last week. Last week we had that mini heat wave. It was 30 degrees plus every day. What's 30 for the Fahrenheiters? So around sort of 90 every day, bone dry, gorgeous, a little bit hot to do any work, but gorgeous. And now this week we're back to 20, if that, which is about 70 in the Fahrenheit. Really grey, cloudy, drizzly, not a huge amount of rain, but just enough to keep things ticking over. But windy, it's been so windy, so much so, and one of the reasons I'm telling you this in the shed is because when we go out there, I'm a bit worried actually that I'm going to end up with no film today because it's so windy. But last weekend, it's so windy, all my climbing things, ostensibly my climbing beans and my cukes, they couldn't get hold of their poles. I mean, they were literally sort of getting hold of the pole and then the wind was flinging them off again. So all my climbing beans were horizontal and finding, for instance, pepper plants and wrapping up on pepper plants. It's like, no, a pepper plant is too small for you to climb. So I've actually had to tie my climbing beans in to the poles. But I've just had a quick look now and it looks like that's worked a treat. They've grown another sort of 6-7 inches in some cases since then, and they are now on the poles. They just needed that little bit of anchoring because, I mean, literally they were being flung off the poles. Likewise, things like cucumbers, which don't climb by winding like the beans, but rather by putting out their little tendrils, and the little tendrils act like little hands and they grab on. And if they can grab on and stay there for a little while, those little hands get tighter and tighter and tighter, little iron grip, and there'll be no moving them. But exactly the same happened for them. As soon as they were getting hold of a bit of, you know, their little ladder, they were being blown off again. So they've had a tying in too. Right, excuse me. I think I'm going to attempt to give you a tour of the garden at the beginning of July. What is the date today? It's the 3rd. It's Friday, the 3rd of July. Look, we'll give it a go. We will try to ignore the wind noises. If it's too much, I will just do it again another day, but it will be quite a few days before I get a chance to do it. I've suddenly got a busy few days, birthday and all that, so I'm not going to have a chance to be here again for about another 4 or 5 days, 5 or 6 days. So fingers, look, shut up Vivi, get on with it. Fingers crossed it's not too bad. I can't wait to show you the garden at the beginning of July. Forgive any weeds, forgive my lack of strimming the paths. Haven't had time to do any of that. You can take me as you find me. Well, here we are, as always, at the top of the plot. And the first thing to note is, look at all these buds. Oh my goodness, getting fatter by the day. Right on cue. I mean, this plant gives like clockwork. Pretty much every year, second week of July, they'll start to burst open. Oh, look at you, little ladybird. So I'm chuffed. And on the subject of flowers in this top bed, all of the little cosmos transplants, these are all self-seeded that I scrounged from my neighbour. They're all doing great, they've all taken great. And I'm getting some buds. Oh, that looks like it's going to be a white one. Lovely, I love the white ones. More buds here. So this lot were transplanted about 3 weeks ago. And then I've added a load more on the ends of each that have only been in about 10 days or so. Looking great. Oh, this one's getting ready to flower too. And all of them are underplanted with just a scratching in of calendula. So hopefully in another few weeks, in a month or so, this should be a lovely riot of colour. So that as everyone walks along this central path, let me just show you from this point of view, anyone walking along our main path, they'll get all these beautiful cosmos and calendula smiling at them. Yay! Okay, right, let's get on with the veggies. So, the lentils, they have not enjoyed the heat. They've not enjoyed the dryness at all. They look rubbish. They're coming out. It's no point. They're coming out. You know, last year when I did them, it was as much as ground cover as anything else. But they're really not doing it this year, so it's just not worth bothering. They'll come out and I'm going to put some more brassicas in. So I've got in here my cauliflowers. They're looking okay there, and the kales down there. But at this end, I don't know who's had a go, but you see, someone's had a go at that kale. However, oh, what's that on there? It's just muck. However, there is a little bit of growth showing here, new growth.
So I'll leave it for now and hope for the best. But yeah, excuse me, the lentils can come out, more brassicas in. I can, in the next couple of days or on my next visit, I'll have out, these are the broad beans that I'm leaving for seed saving. Oh, I was going to say they're good and dry, but they've gotten damp. Oh, so windy. I might actually have these off today because we are having this damp weather. I'll have them off and pop them in the shed because it's so warm and dry in the shed. They'll dry out in no time. Fantastic. Oh, the little California poppy. This sculpture is just going for it. It's such a happy sight, isn't it? This, I mean, could you be any more giddy and gay as a flower than a little Californian poppy? Beautiful colour. Oh, it's so windy, they're wobbly. Okay, enough of that. This is the bed full of coco de pampol. Most of it was direct sown. A few of them are plug-ins. And they're finally starting to colour up. I think the rain has done them the world of good. Ooh, bit of nitrogen, but you can still see this is a real sign of nitrogen deficiency. I don't know if it's going to pick up on the camera, but obviously the leaf is a little bit yellow, but what tends to happen with the nitrogen is you'll have yellowness, but the veins will still stay green. So you almost get like a, I'm trying to think of how you could call the effect. I can't think of how to describe it. But yeah, so they've obviously enjoyed the rain and the nitrogen. Like I say, I have been fertilising them with urine, but I've just not had enough, so I've struggled. Two rows of beans here, climbing beans. On the left, Coco Sophie. On the right, Gigantis. So the Coco Sophie, they're really quite diddly still. You know, they've hardly got going at all. They look great. They look really healthy. They've got a beautiful colour on them. They just need time now. And you can see they are all producing these climbing stems. But yeah, so far, I don't want to jinx myself, but so far pest free in terms of black fly, which have been awful this year. Pest-free and a good colour, fabulous. This side, the Gigantis. Now, oh, this wind is so annoying, sorry guys. Let me show you here. They are a slightly paler green anyway, but they do look like they want to feed. Oh, they're really climbing away. Whee! Look at this one. So this is now as tall as me. So it's basically, well, it's nigh on 6 foot already. Fantastic. And the first flowers. Oh, you precious, beautiful, beautiful things. Gorgeous. Oh, I'm chuffed. There's tons to come. Lovely, 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 tons to come. So yeah, I'm pleased with how all the Gigantes are looking. That's one, they are getting there. But you see what I mean about how, where can I show you? Oh, it's so windy. Can we get some shelter over here from this wind? I'm not sure. But yeah, I'm glad I got them all tied on a bit on Sunday because they just didn't have a chance. Ooh. Okay, I've kind of come, sort of jumped a few beds, but here, this is the Feher Ozum. Actually, they're looking okay. Let's go over there. They're starting to flower too. Let's not miss out on any of the beautiful flowers going on. Oh, sweet little flowers. Oh, look, that's actually, can you see there? That's my first fruit forming. Oh my goodness, how exciting. Yeah, tons of flowers. Fabulous. Yeah, it looks like they're all starting to flower up now. Oh, fruits, two fruits right in the middle there. Can you see? There they are. That's look how tiny they are at the moment, obviously. Fantastic. There was another one where the label is. I came one day, it was just keeled over. I've no idea why. Anyway, it came out. The squash are finally starting to get away. This is cream of the crop. So I'm getting flowers. Now at the moment, they're all male flowers, as we would expect. The plant's going to put out its male flowers first, just to test for pollinators. So if this flower gets a little visit from a bee or some such, then the plant will go, aha, good, there are pollinators around, I'll put out some females. And it is starting to get away. It's putting out a nice, so I can see another flowers, loads more flowers developing, but no signs of females yet. No hurry. So I've got three of them in here. This one, two, three. They all look perfectly happy and healthy. Yeah, loads of beautiful new growth. I think they really enjoyed the heat last week. They're making the most of the moisture now, but we could do that heat and sunshine back. And then over onto the teepees. This is yellow scallop. So there's three, one, two, oh, flower, three. Look at this. Now this is new to me this year. This was some seed given to me. Oh, without my notes, I can't remember by whom, sorry. But I believe it's more like a summer squash. So use it as you would say a courgette. However, apparently, if I leave them on and leave them on and leave them on, the skins will toughen up and, you know, allow me to store it much as I would a winter squash. I don't know that they look like they're going to climb though. They look like they might be wanting to be a clump forming type. Ah! Never mind, they can clump away under the teepee. This is all my plug-in Coco de Pampol. Again, they're looking really pale and pasty, poor things. Yeah, I must try and feed them. Where I've got any gaps now, sort of like this, I'll be sowing extra saladings because I actually forgot to give myself room to do more. Never mind. On this teepee, I've got just one delicata. It's looking okay. I don't know, you know, every year I've tried these the last 4 or 5 years. I can sow 10 seeds and literally just get one, so I'll probably not bother next year, which is a shame because they're a fantastic squash if you're just cooking for one or two. Never mind. And on this side, this is a pearly little straggling loofah. I'm definitely not bothering with loofah again next year, certainly not out here. It was fun to try, but you know, ultimately for a food garden, for a kitchen garden, it's not the right climate, so therefore it's a waste. Oh, I would have so liked my own loofahs though, never mind. Let me come this way to show you these. Oh, sun's coming out, yay! Sun's out, school's out. So under here we've got three Jack be little. Looks like Jack wants to be big. Oh, these are getting away beautifully now. Now this is supposed to be a climber. Oh yes, look at all these flowers to come. Oh, I love this moment every year. I absolutely love it when I'm finding the first flowers and, oh, and speaking of which, look, I'm just to the right of me here, the gigantes, more flowers. Literally every flower gives me the hope of a meal. I just love it. So again, I've got a little bit of space. I can scratch in some more salad leaves. I had three spare tomatoes. One, two, three. They were the very, very last of the spares. They were really straggly and pathetic looking. They've only been in about a week. But they're already, you know, they are greening up. I need to do the side shoots because these are rose de Bern. and I want to use them as a cordon. Ah, look, if they come to something, great. If they don't, well, I couldn't bear to chuck them on the compost heap. And the last squash in this bed are 1, 2, 3 butternuts. This is Waltham butternut. I've generally, well, always grown these as a horizontal squash. I had these spare, so I'm going to have a go at climbing them again. I can see flowers coming. Wunderbar. Oh, great. So there's still, I'm being eaten by the buddleia bush behind me. There's still a ways to go with this bed. Sorry, I'll just show you what I'm just competing with. This is my path, this is where I'm trying to stand. This is my neighbour's buddleia bush, needs a trim. Yeah, so as I was saying, you know, there's a ways to go with this bed yet. It's still, it's not looking exactly lush. Here comes more wind. But you know, I'm willing to bet, shouldn't say that, but I'm willing to bet when we're standing here at the beginning of August, it will be considerably more lush with the squash up the teepees. And then also, you know, literally everywhere in the garden, there are self-seeded calendula, nasturtiums. I let them do it. You know, if they get too many and they're swamping my veggies, I pull them out. But yeah, nasturtiums everywhere. And before long, these paths between, they will disappear with trailing nasturtiums. So yeah, it's beginning to look a lot like my garden, even though it's late. Yay. Okay, here is some lushness. The spuds. Oh, pretty flowers. You know, potato flowers. They're so unassuming, but actually, you are a pretty wee thing, aren't you? So my two rows of main crops, and then my two rows of salads. The salads are quite a bit smaller. Now, in about 2 weeks' time, they'll have been in for 90 days. So I'm going to have my first a little fertile, and I'll probably start with these two. Get them out of the way of the beans. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to having my first treasure hunt with spuds. Oh, one of the best parts of the year. Got my brassicas waiting to go out. They're all in the tunnel. Oh, I'm really not doing well with brassicas this year. My second sowings have come to nothing. A load in here have been eaten. So I think I'm going to be doing a third sowing of brassicas. That's for another day. The salad bed, well, you can see where things got scratched up, can't you? This is supposed to be 1, 2, 3, 4 rows of spinach. There's definitely not 4 rows of spinach. So by way of thinning, I might try and transplant just in clumps. So move a clump from here to here, just let it get on with it. I don't ever do much thinning with the salads. I just let them get on with it and pick, and by picking and eating, thin them. A ton more salads here. And then what I'll do is, over here, I'm going to sow again in a few days so I can keep these salads coming, so I've got a nice succession. I have been picking already. Yum, yum, yum. Another example of, I think, this is where the ground got disturbed, probably by cats. This is supposed to be beetroot. Yes, disturbed by cats. I'm talking about you, buddy. Sloping off, pretending it's not you. So, got a little clump there, then nothing, and then a big clump here. So I will do the same. I'll probably just lift a clump and move it into the gaps. I'll certainly sprinkle a few more seeds in there though. Definitely, because I love my beetroot. The chard has fared a bit better in terms of being mashed up by the cats. You can see on here how I had 4 rows when I sowed. Some are doing better than others. I will do a little bit of thinning and take the thinnings home to eat them, but not a huge amount. I tend to just direct sow these sidey things and leave them to it. and then use them as a cut and come again. Just keep taking a little bit of everything. Fabulous. Oh, this is really happy to see. This is four rows of beurre du roc and claw. 1, 2, 3, 4. Remember the other day I re-sowed this row because nothing had germinated. And actually what I think is I must have just not sowed it, because I've never had zero germination for my own sowed seed before. So all of those that I re-sowed, fabulous. Literally, they all came up. And it's great because actually this is now going to give me a bit of a succession in terms of harvesting and enjoying. So this is a beautiful, beautiful waxy French bean that I grow and harvest for the whole pod. It's one of the very few beans I do for eating fresh rather than drying or having demi-sec. So yeah, chuffed with having that extra row. And then Mark, one of my neighbours, a couple of gardens up, he didn't have any, so I gave him some seed, which he grew on, and then he had three spare. So 1, 2, 3 from Mark up the ways a bit. Thank you, Mark. Because I wasn't sure if my repeat sowing would work, but it did. But you can never have too many beurre du roc and claw. Ah, you know what I was saying about the nasturtiums? Look at the size of this one. I do let them grow wherever they want. However, that's now starting to be bigger than the beans, so I might pull it out. I'd rather the beans get a bit bigger first, and then the nasturtium can sit and play underneath. Yes, I may well do that. Chickpeas are coming along nicely. Little gaps in germination. I won't bother plugging those because these will all fill out now. But it is one of my absolute favourite plants to look at this stage, because look at that foliage. Just love it. And oh, wait until the flowers come. They are the tiniest, prettiest wee things. The bees love them, but every year I think, how are the bees actually getting inside, because the flowers are so tiny? But they do. Yeah, looking forward to that. Probably about 4 weeks off from that at this stage. Oh, I'm spotting weeds as I go around. Out, darned weed, out. It's not too bad. And look, my first calendula out. So, oh, sun's coming out again, lovely. Two rows of calendula, two rows of parsnips. My second sowings of parsnips are done absolutely flap all. The parsnips that are in, they're looking fine. I mean, everything looks so behind, but it'll do. And I think I say the second sowings aren't doing anything. I think I spoke too soon. Oh, spoke too soon. I was going to say that in the gaps here, I can use these gaps for salad leaves as well. But I might hold off. I think I'll hold off for another couple of weeks or so. Yeah, I will. That's fine, actually, because if I put some more salads out now elsewhere, give these parsnips a chance. If they don't come, I'll put a load more salads in. That'll give me three successions of salads. No space wasted. Oh, but this makes me so happy. Yay! Hello, little critter. Oh, isn't that a cheerful, gloriously happy sight? I look at these as well and I think of slathering my skin in the middle of winter. Yay! So originally I sowed all calendula officinalis, but I guess some of them have been cross-pollinated over the years, because I'm ending up with brown centres, orange centres, whatever. They all still make beautiful, beautiful oils and balms. So that's just the first few of, look at this, of very, very many to come. I left One, two, three, four, or is it four random volunteer tomatoes in. I don't know what they are. I think they might be rose de bain. Yeah, not sure. But you know what? Shh, leave them in, see what happens. Yay! These parsnips are looking nice. Nice, but still a bit tiny. Oh well, size isn't everything at this time of year. I'll be patient. Righty-ho. So, nothing much to say here. These are the, the white onions. Oh, gusty. White onions, just growing. Oh, it's getting too windy. Red onions, just growing. Reseeded carrot bed, not growing. Well, apart from the calendulas that are in them. Oh, do you know what? I think these are like the sort of double fluffy headed ones that Paul really enjoyed last year and wanted me to save seed from. But they went over before I could remember to label which were the big fluffy ones. So, because this is just one flower on its own here in the not carrot bed, brilliant. I know that this is the one to save for Paul. Paul, you'll have some fluffy calendula seeds. The little smattering of leeks, which I will pull up and use as almost like spring onions. But honestly, this bed this year, oh, it's just not doing it. Never mind. I will resow. I'll give it one more go because honestly, I can't imagine a winter without carrots. And I have in the past, I have had to do three sowings. Grr. Oh, just we go to the top of this bed. Poor beans being whipped around. I've got some baloshi, helder, three lots of Trail of Tears, and some gigantis. Look, you can see what's happening with this one, where it's been flapped around in the wind. It's ended up grabbing hold of itself because... Oh, hello, missus. Sorry, did I disturb you? Yeah, I think I'm going to have to get the string out and give that one a hand too. So they're not exactly... These are the Trail of Tears. They're not massive yet, but they are growing. They've got really healthy growing tips. They're not too bad, the colour. Oh, this one has managed to cling on. Well done. Well done, little lass. The helder are a little bit further ahead, up to here, so they're about 4 feet now. Oh, this one, 5 feet. Good. They just needed that bit of help to get anchored. Right, I got distracted by beans. Here's the flint corn. That's greened up beautifully. It's growing away now, so happy days. Happy days. Good job, sweet corns. Not sweet corns, flint corns. Good job, flint corns. Well done. Congratulations. You're doing good work. More of the cocoa de pampol that were plugs. Again, pretty pasty looking. Desperate for a bit of nitrogen feed. One solitary surviving fennel seedling. Isn't that beautiful, though? Gorgeous seedlings. And on the other side, where I resowed, they are starting to come. Oh, please survive, please survive. I would really, really love some fennel risotto in, September. Fingers crossed. The celery, looking fab. Look how that's gone lush and robust. I mean, look at this one. Gorgeous. Really, they astonish me every year because they're such spindly little things when they go in. So these have been in about just shy of 4 weeks, and already, I mean, they look like they're desperate to give me a feed. Don't worry, little ones, I will be eating you soon. And then there were two on the end, this one, and this one, they were really massacred by the slugs. When they'd obviously finished on the fennel, they came here. But I left them in because there was just the tiniest signs of life in each. And I'm so glad I did, because they're trying to come back. They are trying. Yay. But if they don't, well, because I use my celery as a cut and come again, there is absolutely plenty here to feed me and keep me going. Oh, I can't wait, can't wait. I'm finally at that stage where I'm kind of believing that, yes, I am going to be eating from this garden this year. There's green stuff. Woohoo! Right, let's come back down. Oh, let's start at this end. Come behind the rose bush. Oh, just to say as well, in here, can you see? Might be a bit hard to see amongst all the branches, but this is the celery I'm saving for seed. There's teeny tiny little flowers. So what I'll have to do is, as these flowers start to come out, I'll have to get little organza bags of some description, something really, really fine mesh, muslin maybe, to tie around them so the seeds drop into my bags rather than onto the soil. It's got a stalk like a tree trunk now. Look at the thickness of that stalk. Beautiful. Under here for company, it has one. And then on the other side, two more Waltham butternuts. They're okay. So these went in last of all the squash. These were in their pots the longest, so I would expect them to be a little bit behind all the others. And you can probably... Oh, now it is starting to put out a bit of a leader. You weren't supposed to be coming in this direction though. So much for that direction idea. But it's neighbours, you can see they are now starting to get away. Beautiful. So I've got four Walthams on this side. Let me step back so you can see. Yeah, four on this side. And then here I've got my Muscat de Provence. That's got, oh yeah, lots of flowers developing in there. Brilliant. And just a ways along, this is the Rouge Vif d'Etampes. This is the one that everyone calls the Cinderella pumpkin. Tons of flowers coming. They're all male at the moment, of course. I can't wait to see the girls arrive. But yeah, they're all looking fine. They're all actually... You know what, I think they're probably doing a little bit better than I was expecting. I think that warmth last week really, really helped. Oh, I know it helped me, I loved it. Look, you see, this is where I tied, this is a, what have we got here? This is a bolotti, and I had to tie it on a few days ago, which has obviously helped it a bit, but it's really struggling to find the pole. They swing around. I mean, so slowly you can't see it with the naked eye, but they swing and swing until they find something to latch onto. And obviously as it's swinging around and finding the pole like that, the wind is then whipping it off again. I think I'll do some tying before I leave today. Oh, the cukes. The cukes are really starting to get away now. And there are a mass, an absolute mass of flowers, which you can't see because of all the leafage. But trust me, there are a lot of flowers in here. Look, tons and tons and tons. Yay, happy days. Looking for the girls. Oh, I see girl flowers. That's a girl. That's a girl. Oh, I'll be having cucumbers. Yay, brilliant. So yeah, I'm chuffed with those, and they are, as you can see, they're starting to climb. But as with everything else, they're needing a bit of help because of the wind. And then in front we've got the orange bell peppers, and I've just noticed this one is looking very poorly compared to the rest. I'm not sure why. I may pull it out, because if there's something wrong with it, I don't want it to be spread. And I've got plenty more. I won't be short of them. Yeah, I think I'll have that one away. The tomatoes. Oh, this is such a joyous sight. Hang on, I'm going to bring you around this way. Delaying the moment, delaying the gratification. They've really started to get going now. Finally, really beautiful, robust, healthy, deep green growth. I'm chuffed to see that. So it is a week ago that I did all that tying in and the taking out the side shoots, and they already need doing again. That's what I love about tomatoes, is once they decide to get going, there's no stopping you. Wow, these stems are really thickening up too. Wowzers. Oh, and, exciting moment. Not you, Rusty. Well, you are exciting, but not in a veggie way. Look, my first little teeny tiny dross. This is on one of my gardener's ecstasies. A few more here. These are related to Gardener's Delight. I've never grown them before. Oh, but I can't wait to taste. Fantabulous. Oh. Oh, and on its little sister plant here and here. Oh my goodness, the things which make us happy, eh? And loads more trusses and flowers coming. Wonderful. I think when I was doing the tying and just general cares and checking over the other day, I think it looks like, I seem to remember that every plant has got at least one flower truss now. Oh, this is Gardener's Delight. So I know from that every plant is going to give me at least some tomatoes. Oh, I'm so pleased. You know, if you remember how they looked, the state of them when they went in. And do you remember at the time I said, have faith? That's why. Right, I'm going to hurry up a bit now, because this has been a long, windy one. Windy in so many ways. My path is gradually disappearing under this beautiful sea of lavender. My goodness, it is so gorgeous. This is a sight every year. Well, I've only had it for the last couple of years, but the sight of this lavender, honestly, it makes me beyond happy. God, it's gorgeous, isn't it? Full of bees. Okay, so the herb bed is filling out nicely. The purple hyssop is out. Oh, bees are in. The white hyssop's on its way. The Verbena benariensis, that this was a little division from Gary's plot, and it looked half dead because I didn't pick it up for ages. It survived, it's doing fine. Now, in the next couple of weeks or so, there's going to be some changes, both in here and at the far end of the cold frame, but I will tell you about that in a couple of weeks' time. Yeah, some changes and some rejigs. And also over here, it slightly relates to this, my Taunton Dean trunk. I mean, look at the size of that trunk, it's crazy. This was massacred by the pigeons and the whitefly, absolutely beyond saving. However, I do have this one okay branch left. So in the next couple of days, well, next week when I'm back, my absolute priority is to get some cuttings from this before I lose it completely. Then it's going to come out, and like I say, yeah, generally in this area around the deck, fence, cold frame, herb bed, there are going to be some changes. Oh, just while we're by the cold frame, that's the loofah I'm trying to grow indoors, as it were. Oh, it's reached the ceiling. Can you see it's right up there now? I think I need to help that wind along the pole rather than the actual glass. I'll get that tied in. There's some spare peppers in the grow bag there. Actually, these bags need watering. I left the roof open on purpose so the rain could get in, but they look quite dry. I'll check with my finger first. I won't water if it's okay. But, oh, and that bit, I can't see properly, where am I pointing? That bit, that needs tying in and guiding up to the pole too. I wonder if this will work. Who knows? Good to try though. What else? Oh yes, the grow bag potatoes. These are massive and leery. So, like I was saying in the ground potatoes, these have been in nearly, they're coming up for 90 days in the middle of July. So what I'll do is I'm going to harvest these two and one of the ones in the garden on the same day, so we can just have a little look and contrast to see the difference in growing between in the bag and in the ground. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing how that will turn out. Oh, I want to do it today. Patience, Vivi. The blueberries, most of them are still not blue, but oh, that's almost a harvest. I don't know if you can see, the light's quite bright, isn't it? And then there's the tool, but there are blue ones there. Yep, you're coming home with me in a second. Wow, things are looking dry despite the rain. The Doulon de Londe peppers. Actually, these look really pale compared with these. They're the same batch. I'm wondering if they don't like the St. John's wort. Because also the achocha in with the St. John's wort, compared to its neighbour, is also really pale and yellow. That absolutely tells me that neither of them like sharing with a St. John's wort, which means the St. John's wort will probably have to go. Oh, sweet peas, yeah, they seem to be coming to an end, so I think now I'm going to leave them to set seed for me. There are a few new ones coming, but they seem to have suddenly, I think it was the heat last week, they seem to have suddenly stopped. Maybe I'll give them a few more days, see what happens. Anyway, they've been lovely. I've appreciated each and every single little one of them. Yay! And that, my friends, is that. Oh my goodness. It's a beautiful day. I mean, I love a bright and breezy day. It's rubbish for filming. But my goodness, it looks like I'm going to have a garden this year. Well, I have got a garden this year. Honestly, I didn't think I was going to get there, but well, I should have had a little bit more faith in myself. I am chuffed to see everything growing. And really, apart from a bit of yellowness in the Coco de Pampol, I think everything is looking really, really healthy, bursting with life. And it's just for want now of sunshine and rain. It'll go mental in there. Bring it on. And you, my happy little herb bed. Oh, well done, plants. Well done, all of you. You've all done marvellous work this year. I'm very, very proud of each and every one of you. Oh, are you waggling your thank you, Lavender? Okay, lovely people. Well, this was supposed to be a quickie. It's turned into a longie. And I've still no idea about the sound quality until I get home. But hopefully, it was okay. And I will see you in a few days' time. Cheerio, everyone.